you read it, if you read it and there is no question on SPDF, don't worry. The world is still going to be a beautiful place. And just that you know a little bit more than the average of the world. So learn the whole thing. Whatever has been taught to you, please make sure that you're learning. Some portions, there will not be any questions. So be happy about it. Don't worry. Similarly, some things which I haven't told you may come in the exam. Again, don't worry. Just that we have, it's a learning experience. So we have to learn it. Okay. So very good. I have waited for 5 minutes almost. Still, there are people yet to come. So anyway, I will not continue to wait anymore. So I hope my screen is clear. Few messages. If my audio is heard and if my screen is clear, and then I will move on. Okay, very happy to hear, Swatika, that everything is going good. Okay, good to hear from Harish also that everything is clear. Okay, good. So with that brief thing, my dear friends, I will tell you, do not prepare for exams. Prepare for learning. Prepare for your future. Prepare for learning. The marks that I give don't make any difference to anyone. But the learning that you take is all yours. Nobody can take it away from you. Okay, so so read the 3 chapters completely. That's the moral of the story. Moral: read the 3 chapters fully. If you feel lazy, don't read the docs. If you feel even more lazy, don't read deleted portion. If you feel even more lazy, don't read quantum model of an atom. That is that SPDF part, that part alone, don't read. That is if you are at the 4th level of laziness. Okay, so depending on your stage, you pick. Okay, so here is a question. So the question is, what is the ionization enthalpy of hydrogen? Okay, there's a question. What is the ionization enthalpy of hydrogen? Okay, so now let's try to understand what this is. But before I go there, let me just check one last time. Sir, can we use DC Pandey for both physics and chemistry? Oh, I didn't know that DC Pandey is there in chemistry also. But yeah, Barney, you can use. You can use. My only problem with them is at least 30-40% of what they have written is out of syllabus. Okay, so it becomes very difficult to find out what is in syllabus. And you don't want to buy a book and then keep thinking what is there in syllabus, what is not there. Anyway, let's come back. The question is, what is ionization enthalpy of hydrogen? So first, let me explain, what do you mean by ionization? Ionization refers to the removal, of one or more electrons from outermost shell. This outermost shell is also referred to as the valency shell. So removal of one or more electrons from the outermost shell is called ionization. If you remove one electron, it's called the first ionization. First ionization energy or enthalpy. If you remove two electrons or the second electron, after removing the first, you are removing the second electron. So it's called the second ionization enthalpy. Now, in your exam, I have asked a question. Why is the second ionization? I am asking a question. Is the second ionization enthalpy more or less or equal to first ionization enthalpy? What will you say? I have asked you a question like this. The second ionization enthalpy, is it more or less or equal to the first ionization enthalpy? What will you answer? So I am getting some quick answers. Some people are saying first answer is more, then less, then more. It is greater, more. Arni has written a good explanation also. Very good. More than the first. Okay. So except for one answer, everything else is more. Very good. So more is the correct answer. The problem is this, that see, the second ionization, you are removing one electron from a positively charged atom. Now, positively charged means what? Already there is deficiency of electron. Now, in deficiency of electron, you are removing one electron. So, definitely, there is going to be a more difficult. Yes, definitely it will be more difficult. So that is what I am saying. The second ionization enthalpy will always be more than the first ionization enthalpy. Okay, good. So let's learn a little bit more about ionization enthalpy. But before that, I have a small call. Just 1 second. Sir, ma'am has come. Please explain to her what Seekers is doing, how Seekers is doing, what are the files we are maintaining. My class is over by 10:45. By 10:50, I'll be there. Before that, please explain to us, show her the learning room, show her the people who are meeting, everything. Okay. Yeah, so I'll explain to you what ionization enthalpy means. See, ionization enthalpy, understand everything in physics and chemistry has a proper definition. Yeah, so ionization enthalpy is the energy required to liberate or remove an electron from the valency shell from the valency shell of an isolated gaseous, G-A-S-E-O-U-S, gaseous atom. Okay, its unit is kilojoule per mole. So first let us write down the definition. The energy required to liberate or remove an electron from the valency shell of an isolated gaseous atom. So suppose I have sodium. I have sodium and I want to remove an electron from sodium. First, I have to convert sodium solid to sodium liquid. Then I have to convert sodium liquid to sodium gas. Only then I will get an isolated gaseous atom. So from that isolated gaseous atom, if I remove one electron, the amount of energy for this step is what is known as ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy, and it is always expressed in terms of moles. Do you understand? So if I have sodium has to convert into sodium liquid. Sodium liquid has to become sodium gas. Only then I will get isolated gaseous atom. If I have hydrogen has to first become 2H. Hydrogen, HH, there is a bond. So this bond has to be broken. And I have to get 2H. Then from that 2H, suppose I get H plus plus an electron. Now the energy required for this step is what is called as the ionization enthalpy. So if I have an isolated hydrogen atom, I know that I need 13.6 electron volts. This is for one atom. So this is equal to 13.6 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules per atom. But I want it per mole. So into 6.023 into 10 power 23 will tell me how much energy I need per mole. And that is going to look like 13.6 into 1.6 into 6.023 into 10 power 4 joules. So now I can find this. I can do some multiplication and I can get this. Can you quickly work on this and then get it? Is there any doubt? Here is the previous slide. So look at this slide. Make a note of the definition. Ionization enthalpy is always given in kilojoule per mole. So you have to calculate whatever you are doing for one mole. And one mole is 6.023 into 10 power 23 particles. So that's it. Let me see if there are any questions. Sir, is photoelectric effect ionization of metal by light? Absolutely it is. It is always per mole. Yes, it is always per mole. By definition itself, it is per mole. Sir, it is one electron or one mole of electrons. It is one mole of electrons. Sir, can you do for Mg also and explain? Okay, I can. I have no problems. Okay, so this is the definition of ionization enthalpy. The energy required to liberate or remove an electron from the valency shell of an isolated gaseous atom. Its unit of ionization enthalpy is kilojoule per mole. Because it is kilojoule per mole, I have to answer for one mole. Now for one atom, I know 13.6. So, okay, sodium, I explained to you. Now, same thing you want to do with magnesium also. We have no problem. So magnesium is a solid. So first you convert it to magnesium liquid. Everything has to be first converted into liquid. Then you convert it into magnesium gas. Now, once you convert it into magnesium gas, now you take one magnesium gas. Now magnesium gas, you make it release Mg plus plus one electron. Now this is known as first ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy. Okay, then from Mg plus you remove one more electron. Now this is known as the second ionization enthalpy. Yeah, Now, second ionization enthalpy. So for Mg, you will have two ionization enthalpy values. You will have the first ionization enthalpy value and you will have the second ionization enthalpy value. Now, this is for one electron, but ionization enthalpy is always for one mole. This is also always for one mole. Okay, and you will see that the second ionization enthalpy is much higher than the first ionization enthalpy. Okay, so this is what ionization enthalpy is. So first you make a note of this. Second, you please complete this calculation. Please complete it. Please complete it and give a value to it. So, so if I was doing it, this is 9.6. So I'll say almost it is equal to 10. So I'll say this is 13.5 into 10 into 10 power 4. So I will say it is equal to 13.5 into 100 kilojoules. So 1350 kilojoules. Okay, so it is 1350 kilojoules. So that is the approximate ionization energy for hydrogen. So that is the ionization enthalpy for hydrogen. Okay. Yeah. So work on it. Okay, so where am I? Yeah, so I have explained to you about this. Then let me just look at the questions. Yes, you have to multiply, you have to find out. Okay. I told you, bhai, I did approximation. You all have to multiply. In the exam, I will tell you what you have done. So don't worry about it. You conduct an exam for me, I will do it correctly. Don't worry about it. Okay, I have assumed 9.6. I have taken 9.6 as 10. So you have to multiply it exactly. Sir, how did we get 13.6? That is the energy at the lowermost shell for hydrogen. No, hydrogen in the first shell is how much? 13.6 electron volts. So that's how we got the 13.6. Calculations only is taking so much of your time and energy. Okay, so what have I done? I have taken 10 power minus 19 into 10 power 23 is equal to 10 power 4. That is 10 power minus 19 plus 23. That is equal to 10 power 4. Okay. And then I have multiplied all these quantities. Yeah. So I have taken an approximation. I have not done any working. You all are working with pen paper. So definitely your answers will be better than mine. My job is only to teach you logic, not to spoon feed you how to multiply 13.6 into 9.6 and all that stuff. Okay, so that I hope you all are doing. Yeah. Why is it different for two cases? Yeah, to remove a second electron is more difficult than to remove one electron. I don't understand, Kavi Priya, how the H question slide, na? I don't understand. Or show the H question slide. Okay. Here. What is the ionization enthalpy of hydrogen? So I told you what ionization is first. Ionization refers to the removal of one or more electrons from the outermost shell, which is also referred to as the valency shell. Okay, so if this is all done, then Sir, for that question, we have included 6.02, that is per mole. Always ionization enthalpy is per mole. Why it is different from two different cases? It is different for two different cases because if you remove one electron, so if first magnesium is neutral, then you are removing one electron. So now it has become positively charged. So when you are removing the second electron, you need more energy. You need more energy to remove the second electron than the first electron. Why? Because now you are removing electron from positive charge body. So it is more difficult to remove electrons from positive charge body than otherwise. Okay, so this is 4, this is slide 5. This is 6. This is 7. Okay. So here is the next question. The question is, what is the largest and smallest wavelength of Balmer series in hydrogen spectrum? Okay, what is the largest and smallest wavelength of Balmer series in hydrogen spectrum? Okay, friends, before I answer this question, there is one more small thing that I want to explain to you. Suppose I have a cylinder here, a transparent glass cylinder, which has hydrogen atoms in it, or hydrogen atoms in it. Okay, which has hydrogen atoms in it. Suppose I heat it. So this is a heating source. Okay, if there is a heating source, hydrogen atoms gain energy and electronic transitions take place. Okay, now once electronic transitions take place, what happens is an electron jumps from shell 1 to some higher shell. Okay, now when you leave it like that, it will jump back to its original shell, liberating energy. Now this is what is referred to as a emission spectrum. So how is the emission spectrum of hydrogen? So they'll give you a question, draw the emission spectrum of hydrogen. So what I'll be expecting you to do is I'll expect you to draw the nucleus, first shell, second shell, third shell, fourth shell. Like this, I would expect you to draw at least 6 shells. Okay. Then higher to first shell. So you will say this is the Lyman series. Higher to second shell. Then you will call this the Balmer series. Then higher to third shell. Then you will call the Paschen series. Like this, I will expect you to draw. This is an emission spectrum. Emission spectrum, when an excited electron returns back to its original state or ground state. So this is an emission spectrum. Okay, now on the other hand, you have something called as an absorption spectrum. Okay, so now suppose I have the same container with hydrogen atoms. Same container with hydrogen atoms, and I throw light, all wavelengths. Now, this light will interact with the hydrogen atoms, and only some of them will be absorbed. So, what I see on this side is I see those rays which are not absorbed. Okay, so suppose this is absorbed, I don't see that. I've seen that here. So next one I don't see, the next one I'll see, and so on. Okay, so in an absorption spectrum, all the lines which are visible in the emission spectrum will be absent. Okay, all lines of emission spectrum will be absent, because those are the ones which the hydrogen has absorbed. Okay, so that is the difference between an absorption spectrum and an emission spectrum. So if you are asking me, why are we learning about absorption spectrum, why are we not learning about emission spectrum? Because it is more easy to do the experiment with absorption spectrum than with emission spectrum. Okay, it is more easy to find out which lines are missing than to find out what is the wavelength of the light. Okay, so that is why the absorption spectrum is also learned. They both are the same thing. In one case, light is energy is absorbed and radiated. In the other case, energy is only absorbed. So, you know what is missing. Am I clear? Sir, please be slow. Both types of spectrum. Hey, Shahrukh, slide 10. Divya is still in slide 4. Emission spectrum is discontinuous. All spectrums are discontinuous. All spectrums are discontinuous. They don't have to be continuous. So continuity, discontinuity is not the main thing. The main issue is what is absent here is present here, and what is present here is absent there. That's the whole thing. Okay, this is slide 4. Okay, so emission, E-M-I-S-S-I-O-N, emission spectrum. Refers to the wavelengths emitted when an excited gas is allowed to cool down . Okay, the wavelengths observed refer to the different transitions, to the energy released from electronic transition. Okay. So in an emission spectrum, energy is released. Can we make some notes? I'll wait now. In an emission spectrum, energy is released. in an emission spectrum, energy is released. Okay, so this is an emission spectrum. Now, if I in the exam, they'll ask you to draw one. So you can draw this. Electrons coming from 1 to 2 to 1, 3 to 1, 4 to 1. Call it, name it Lyman series, Balmer series, Bastian series, and so on. So here, excited electrons from higher energy levels are coming back to the ground state. Okay. This is the emission spectrum. This is the emission spectrum. Okay. So if this is over, yeah, I'm now waiting. I'm waiting for a few minutes. Okay. I can ask. I would ask to draw absorption spectrum, emission spectrum. Yes, yes. I will wait for one more minute. No problem. So first you finish emission spectrum. Okay. Okay, next I will go to absorption spectrum. Absorption spectrum. So in absorption spectrum, energy is absorbed. Energy is absorbed. Now the lines visible, the lines visible in emission spectrum are absent here. The electrons absorb only those wavelengths, okay, which are permissible. Okay, only those wavelengths which are permissible, the electrons absorb. So now what do? You took the same container with the same gas. And then you threw all kinds of wavelengths. You threw a continuous spectrum here. But what you see here is that certain lines are missing. Which are those lines missing? Exactly those which hydrogen has absorbed. Now, which are the ones which hydrogen has absorbed? Hydrogen has absorbed those which will require to go from 1 to 2. Those which will require to go from 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 1 to 5. That is the Balmer series. Then they have absorbed those which require to go from 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 2 to 5. So this is the Lyman series. This is the Balmer series, the Bastian series, the Brackett series, the Fund series. So only those lines were absorbed. So in this case, those lines are missing. So while in an emission spectrum energy is released, in an absorption spectrum, energy is absorbed. Okay, so that is the difference between a emission spectrum and an absorption spectrum. How is an emission spectrum produced? I told you, you take a tube, you heat up the gas, and then you leave it. Then the light will come. So that light is the emission spectrum. Or you wait, sit, let the sun rise, and you get the light from the sun. That is the hydrogen spectrum, emission spectrum. Sir, are spectrums discontinuous because of photons, sir? No. Spectrums are discontinuous because of availability of wavelength. All wavelengths are not available. Sir, can we say emission spectrum to be exact opposite? Exactly, it is that. 11th slide for 5 seconds. Exactly 5 seconds, 11th slide. Okay, slide. Second one, second two, second three, second four, second five, over 5 seconds. Bonus. Okay. So, in absorption spectrum, certain lines are missing. In emission, those lines have been absorbed. So, those lines are missing. In emission spectrum, only those lines are there because that is what is being emitted by the gas. Okay. So, emission spectrum, absorption spectrum, and over. Look at questions for 2 more minutes and then done. Which is the largest? And now we have to go to that. Yeah. So, over. Sir, you didn't answer the question yet. That we have to go now. We have to go now. So now the question asked was, which is the largest and smallest wavelength in the Balmer series of hydrogen atom? Why I deviated to that is, they will say which is the largest and smaller wavelength in the absorption spectrum of Balmer series. In the Balmer series of absorption spectrum of hydrogen atom or emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. Both are the same. Okay. In absorption, we note it by its absence. In emission, we note it by its presence. So, it is like me taking attendance in school and taking attendance at home. Both are the same. But taking attendance at home, you will be present, means in school you are absent. Assuming that there are only 2 places to go. Okay. So, now let's come back to Balmer series. Balmer series is the second series. First one is the Lyman series. Next one is the Balmer series. Balmer series means the electrons are coming from 3 to 2. They're coming from 4 to 2, they're coming from 5 to 2, they're coming from 6 to 2, and so on. Yeah. Now, largest wavelength which corresponds to least energy. So, this one is the least energy. Yeah. So, how much energy are we talking of? We are talking about 13.6 into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by 3 squared. So we are talking about 13.6 into 5. So 9 minus 4, 5 by 36. So much of electron volts we are talking. Now I have to report it in wavelength. So we will have to convert this to wavelength and we will answer. The next, the smallest wavelength will have highest energy. So what is the highest? It can come from infinity to second shell. Infinity to second shell means it will have 13.6 into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by infinity squared. Now, infinity squared is 0. So smallest wavelength will have energy 13.6 by 4 eV. Largest wavelength will have energy 13.6 into 5 by 36 eV. Okay. But I have to convert these 2 wavelengths. So I will wait till you finish this. Once you finish this, I'll go to new slide and convert this to wavelength. Okay, so if it is done, I will convert. Okay, before that, let me just check. Sir, for wavelength, we can use, see, Kavipriya, you can use Rydberg constant. If they have given you the value, you can use. But if they have not given you the value, then it becomes very difficult. Okay, that is why I don't like to use the Rydberg constant. For the shortest wavelength, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is equal to infinity, right? So we should not take one which comes from infinity as longest. Obviously, because the energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. Energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. More energy, less wavelength, and vice versa. So when we heat, we get emission spectrum. Similarly, when we cool, no. When you heat, you the electrons get excited. You don't get a spectrum. The electrons get excited. Now, when you allow them to cool, only then they will jump. Only when they jump, they will release energy. Yeah, if you can remember, I am okay with it. There is no problem. Harini, not now. I've been showing you the slides only till now. And 30 minutes, I've only shown slides. Okay, so now let's convert it. So, shortest wavelength is equal to 13.6 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 by 4. So many joules. So this is equal to Hc by lambda. So this is equal to Hc by lambda. So I can say lambda is equal to 4 into Hc. Hc 6.637 into 10 power minus 34 into C. C is how much? 3 into 10 power 8 into divided by 13.6 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. So this will give you the lambda value. So there is just one calculation I have to do carefully to be able to get my answer. Yeah. So that is what I have to do. That's it. So now this one calculation you all do. So the problem is, where will you use Rydberg constant? So if you want to use Rydberg's constant, Rydberg's constant is, if they give you the transition, then you can use. Okay, so you will say 1 by lambda is equal to RH into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by 3 squared. Then 1 by lambda is equal to RH into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by infinity squared. Perfect. You can use this also. If you know the value for RH, you can use this also. This will give you the longest wavelength. This will give you the shortest wavelength. Okay, you can use this also. Perfect, no problem. Whichever one you are comfortable with, you can use. Okay, so I will wait for a few minutes. Calculations you will have to do. Don't expect me to do the calculations. This is a question which is there in your book, and they have not given you the RH value. Okay, so yeah. So if you are done, let me look at the questions. Yes, sir. Okay, good. Good. So when the heat we okay, Harini, I hope you are able to understand. Previous slide na which one? Once again. Sir, can you give an example for other two models of this sum? For other two models means? I don't understand. Ido 13th slide, 14th slide, 13th slide, 14th slide. I will give you examples. Just hang on. And I have sent you guys some homework, but I am seeing that nobody has done. I have sent you some homework on oxidation state, reduction state. I am not getting any response for that. 2-3 homeworks are pending. No response. So today after 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, please check what are the homeworks and then try to do them. Okay. So this is over. I'm assuming this is over. Okay. Now, if this is over, then yeah. Okay. So guys are comfortable. Fine. Good. No problem. Another question. Okay. Similar. Another question. They have told you that the energy of an electron in hydrogen atom is minus 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 by n squared joules. Okay, what is the longest wavelength that can cause a transition from second shell to third shell? What is okay? No need to say two third shell. This is not required. Sorry, not required. What is the longest wavelength that can cause a transition from second shell? So now you have to understand, if there is a transition from second shell and you are talking about longest wavelength, you are talking about least energy. See, even this you can do by RH. So you can simply say 1 by lambda is equal to RH into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by 3 squared, because that will be the longest wavelength. Alternatively, what you can do is you can now try to find out, this is the second shell, right? From the second shell. So from the second shell, longest wavelength means it will go to the third shell. So the energy will be 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by 3 squared. And this is equal to Hc by lambda. Okay. So now you can calculate this and get the value for lambda. So either you can do this or you can do this. I somehow now seem to be liking this one, because if you do 200 questions with RH, the value for RH will be in your memory. Now, once RH is there in your memory, you can keep doing these questions without any difficulty. Okay, so the question is, the energy of an electron in a hydrogen atom is given as minus 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 by n squared joules. What is the longest wavelength that can cause a transition from second shell? So longest wavelength means you are talking of minimum energy. Minimum energy means you are talking of transition from second to third. So if you are talking of transition from second to third, I can say 1 by lambda is equal to RH into 1 by 2 squared minus 1 by 3 squared. Or you go by the energy. So the energy difference is equal to Hc by lambda. Now cross multiply, get the value for lambda. Okay. Yeah, now cross multiply and get the value for lambda. Okay, now let me see what are the questions. So now there are no questions. I have to do second sum in homework sum. So I don't know which is the homework. Sir, is the answer for shortest wavelength equal to this? Yes. I say it today. It will be, I will do it today. Okay, good. I saw it today. I will do it today. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Means lower energy. Longest wavelength means lower energy. Lower energy. Longest wavelength means lower energy. Lower energy means it should be only from the next one to the previous one. As the shells increase, the energy increases. As the shells energy, see, this is the nucleus. This is the first shell. This is the second shell. This is the third shell. Okay, this is the fourth shell. Now, if you're talking about lowest energy of Lyman series, it will come from here to here. Okay. Then if you're talking about the highest energy in Lyman series, it will come from infinity to here. Yes. Then one more thing, all of you please remember,
Balmer series belongs to visible spectrum. Balmer series belongs to visible spectrum. Balmer series belongs to visible spectrum. So sometimes they won't tell you Balmer series. They'll ask you to find out what is the lowest wavelength of the visible series in hydrogen spectrum. Only the Balmer series is visible. Other series are not visible. Also, you see, you have Lyman, you have Balmer, you have Paschen, you have Brackett, and then you have Fund series. Right? Now, this is visible. This will have more energy. So, it is ultraviolet. Ultraviolet. Visible. Visible is Vibgyor. Now, this is high energy. This is low energy. So, visible. So, this is ultraviolet. All these are infrared. Infrared radiations. These are ultraviolet radiations, and Balmer series refers to the visible spectrum. Okay, Balmer series refers to the visible spectrum. Now, I may ask you to derive all these energy formulas in your exam. So, there are two things that will help us in the derivation. First one, MVR. Is equal to nh by 2 pi. This is angular momentum is quantized. Angular momentum is quantized. Okay. Then the second one is that the centripetal force mv squared by r is equal to kze squared by r squared. That is the electrostatic force provides for the centripetal force. Electrostatic force provides for the centripetal force. So mv squared by r is equal to kze squared by r squared. So I have two equations. I can solve them. First, cancel this. From the first equation, calculate v. V is equal to nh by 2 pi mr. From the second equation, calculate V squared is equal to KZE squared by MR. Now, square this and equate it to this. So, N square H square by 4 pi square M square R squared is equal to KZE squared by MR. Okay. So, 1M cancels. 1R cancels. So, I need R. R is equal to 4 pi squared k z e squared m by n square h square. Okay, now after this, I would expect you to supply the values. If you supply the values, you will get R is equal to 0.529 into z by n square. Why? Some mistake. R will go up, reciprocal of this. R is equal to, R will go up. So it is n square h square by 4 pi squared k z e squared m. Okay, so it is 0.529 n squared by z. So this is how you can derive the radius. Okay, so work on it. The first one is a Bohr's postulate. The second one is not a postulate. It's the fact that the centripetal force is being supplied by the electrostatic force of attraction. Okay. So, let me check if there are any questions. Yeah, reciprocal of it. Sir, if they ask as infrared, no, infrared they can't ask. They can only ask visible. Because there is only one which is visible. Infrared means all are infrared. You didn't put A at end. That all you put. Sir, when angular momentum, yes, we should still use nh by 2 pi. We should not use L into L plus 1. We should not use L into L plus 1. L into L plus 1 is the modified one based on quantum theory. But in your exam, they'll ask you what is the angular momentum of s orbital. So angular momentum of s orbital is 0. That you should say 0. But here you have to say n. No, you can't say L into L plus 1. How laymen have more energy? More energy means what? Ground state is 13.6. So when you come from 3.4 to 13.6, the energy difference is 10. So as you keep going up, the energy difference keeps reducing. Memorize that. As you come closer to the nucleus, the energy becomes more negative. So Lyman series, you are coming closer to the nucleus. So more negative means more energy is released. Okay. Okay, so friends, done for the day today. See you again tomorrow. Keep doing your homework and keep working hard. More energy, more negative energy. That means suppose you lost 100 rupees, then you are minus 100. Suppose you lost 1000 rupees, you are minus 1000. So which is where do you lose more? Minus 1000, no? So the same way. Okay, so negative of a larger number. Yeah, I can show you slide 15. So here is slide 15. Okay. So good. Bye. How to draw? You can't draw absorption spectrum. You can only say these lines are missing. In absorb, you draw the emission spectrum and say in absorption spectrum, these lines are missing. 8 and 9, I will show. You are saying, yeah. Lehman nuclear attraction is more. Yes. 8 and 9. 8th slide, nothing is there. Only question is there. 9th slide. I told you that I would first tell you about emission and absorption. Okay, goodbye. I am done. Thank you, all of you, thank you. Hey, never use guide for NEET. That is the worst thing that you can do. Never use guide for NEET.